How important is pelvic tilt in yoga? Well, you might have noticed that the topic of the pelvis and which direction it's tilting tends to receive a lot of attention in the yoga world. For example, we tend to hear from many authorities in the yoga world that an anterior pelvic tilt is a widespread postural problem that we need to address and correct. Now, an anterior pelvic tilt is when, say here's my pelvis, is when the pelvis tips forward slightly relative to neutral. So that would be an anterior pelvic tilt. And this is claimed to be an issue that can cause pain and dysfunction in the body. And that's why you'll tend to see a lot of fix your anterior tilt or address your anterior tilt suggestions online and on social media. Now, on the flip side, there are also many authorities who will tell us the opposite, which is that instead of an anterior pelvic tilt, the widespread problem is the posterior pelvic tilt. And then that would be where the pelvis is posteriorly tilted, so it's tipped backwards in space relative to neutral, also called a tucked pelvis. And these authorities tell us that most people need to fix this postural problem by untucking the pelvis to return to neutral. Now, the truth is that multiple scientific studies have actually looked at resting posture of the pelvis, and they've revealed something interesting for us. So these studies have looked at a range of populations from kids through adults, and they've looked only at healthy, asymptomatic individuals, meaning people with no painful complaints in their bodies. And these scientific studies have revealed for us that the normal resting posture, the most common normal resting posture, is actually a slight anterior pelvic tilt. So the most common default posture of the pelvis is not neutral, but it's actually a slight anterior pelvic tilt. Now, this suggests two things for us to realize in the yoga world. The first is that claims that most people are in a posterior pelvic tilt or a tucked pelvis and that they need to untuck their pelvis and get back to neutral, those claims are not supported by what science would suggest. Science suggests everyone is in fact, well, not everyone, but the majority of people are in fact in an anterior tilt. Now, the other realization from these studies is that claims that the majority of people are in an anterior pelvic tilt and that this is a widespread problem that's causing people pain and dysfunction, that is also not supported by what science would suggest, because these studies reveal to us that this is the normal posture in healthy individuals without painful complaints. So the types of suggestions that we see out there, like online and in social media, about fixing your anterior tilt and suggesting that it's an inherent problem that's going to cause issues in the body, those would be examples of pathologizing normal. So if an anterior pelvic tilt is normal posture in the majority of people, then if we're calling that a bad thing, we're pathologizing normal. And that's not necessarily the most helpful practice because of the psychosocial effects that can have on people. Now, to go off on a brief tangent here, I'll just interject that the idea that an anterior pelvic tilt is inherently problematic was originally put forth by a physical therapist named Valdimir Janda, who was influential in the 1960s. Janda coined a term that you may have heard of before called lower crossed syndrome. And he called the pelvic posture of an anterior tilt, he called that, when someone had this as their default posture, he referred to that as lower crossed syndrome. And he believed that lower cross syndrome was the cause of a lot of musculoskeletal pain and dysfunction in the body. Now, Janda's ideas made sense back in the 1960s based on what was known about the human body at that time. But it's been 60 years since then. We know a ton more about the human body, and Janda's ideas have been largely debunked at this point. So we can now safely move on from these outdated ideas about non-optimal pelvic tilt being an inherent cause of pain and dysfunction in the body. And that also means that in our yoga practice, we can move on from the idea that we need to be consciously micromanaging our pelvis or correcting or fixing our pelvic tilt. For example, in Tadasana pose, we don't need to worry about our pelvic tilt being like incorrect and that we need to make this tiny micro adjustment of a few degrees, either tilting backwards or tilting forwards, whichever it is we think it is, to get to some magical neutral. We don't need to micromanage our pelvic position in that way. We can move on from that approach. However, that does not mean, and I definitely want to emphasize this, that doesn't mean that the pelvic tilt is not important in yoga. The pelvic tilt is important and it plays a big role in our yoga practice, but just coming from a different perspective. So I believe that it's helpful for all of us movers on the yoga mat to be connected with our pelvis and to understand and know how it can move in all of the planes of motion that it can move. And when we have that connection to this region, then we can be more intentional about how we move and position our pelvis to direct the loads where we'd like them to go in any individual pose in the moment. In summary, pelvic tilt doesn't matter in a general sense when it comes to something like posture. Remember that the normal pelvic positioning in healthy individuals is an anterior pelvic tilt, so we don't want to pathologize normal. And then of course, remember that there's just general human variability, so there will be a range of different pelvic positionings, and that's all fine and normal. And then within the context of yoga, pelvic tilt matters in the sense that we want to use it consciously and intentionally to direct the loads where we'd like them to go in our poses. But pelvic tilt doesn't matter in yoga when it comes to just our default resting posture, and it doesn't matter as an inherent cause of or prevention of musculoskeletal pain and dysfunction. If you're experiencing pain in your body that's concerning to you, seek out a physical therapist to help you and work with you, and ideally a physical therapist who stays up to date on the current research in their field. If you appreciated this content, subscribe to my channel so that you can stay up to date on all of the tips that I share.